Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and my favorite way to take screenshots and record my screen, especially these quick little things that I do all the time throughout the day, is Cleanshot. Cleanshot is awesome. I've made multiple videos about it. Full disclosure, I do work with them on their release note videos, so I do make some videos for their channel, but they don't do anything on this channel. They don't pay me to say anything outside of those videos, and I just actually love this app, so I wanted to talk about it today. I like to mention pricing as well. Cleanshot is not free. You do have to pay for it. It's $29. It's a one-time payment, and that gets you 1 year of updates. So every year, if you want to keep getting updates, you just have to pay $29 again per Mac that you're using it on. But let's jump into the three things. So the first thing that's new and is super useful to me is the new highlighter tool. So if I take a screenshot of this part of the site, let's go ahead and hide the browser. If we go into the editor, we can do all the normal things we're used to in CleanShot, but the new highlighter is awesome. I already have it selected, and you used to have to select like exactly the right size of highlight. You don't need to do that anymore. What's awesome is you'll see the cursor change based on what text you're hovering over. It knows what you're hovering over, and it knows how to size it appropriately. It's also going to snap kind of where it starts and stops. So as you hover over things, it's going to stop right at the end of the sentence that you're trying to do. Really awesome. Love how this works. I like to highlight text quite a bit in my screenshots, and this just makes them look a lot nicer. The second thing is an update to backgrounds and presets. So if we go ahead and bring this up here, if we go into the background tool, all the same things are here, but there's two new changes. First, let me auto balance the screenshot and add a little inset. That's gonna be a little better. They've added 10 new gradient backgrounds. So the first 10 were here already, and they've added these 10 new ones. I think a lot of these look pretty good. Some of them are very colorful, very aggressive. Some of them are more subtle, more subdued. I kind of lean towards this one, and you can still save these as presets. So I have a couple presets here. A video preset is one I made recently, and that kind of just sets these settings, and you can basically just apply those quickly. The other new thing here is that if you go in here, there's a default preset. So let's say I'm taking a bunch of these text screenshots in a row, and I want to use the same kind of settings for all of them so they look the same. I'm going to go here, set my default preset to this one for this guy. We'll save this, we're done, cool. And let's scroll down, and now I want to take a screenshot of this paragraph. So I take the screenshot, and down here you're going to see, if I do a quick look, it's already applied that for me. So that looks good. We'll take a screenshot of this. And again, it's doing all these things for me, so all these screenshots look perfectly uniform. This is useful not all the time for me, but enough that it is actually a thing that I'm really happy is there. If you ever want to turn this off, just go back to default preset and set none. Now, the last thing I wanted to show, let's just copy these. If I take a full screen screenshot and just save it to my desktop, if we check out the info on this one, this is 3.8 megabytes, which is pretty big. And sometimes you want to save things at a smaller size. So let's take that same screenshot again, go into the editor, and now inside the crop tool, you actually have the ability to change the image size. So you can set it to a specific pixel resolution if you want, or you can do a percentage. This is a 4K screenshot. If I want to do 1080p, that's 50% on both axes. Resize it, done, save it. And so again, this first screenshot was 3.8 megabytes. This one is 1.1, so a lot smaller. Now, I do actually have a shortcut set up to resize images as well. So if I go to Quick Actions, I have one for resize image, and I can just enter what I want the height to be. So we'll do 1080p, done. It's gonna ask me where I wanna save it. There we go. And so this kind of does the same thing. I screwed it up. That should have been 1920 by 1080, but anyway. That lets me do that, and that's completely unrelated to CleanShot. Unfortunately, that does use another paid app, so if you're looking for a free way to do it, I don't have a free way to do it, but yeah, that's the shortcut. I'll share a link to it in the, let me actually share iCloud link now. Share it, cool. So this will be in the description if you want to check this out. If you use Pixelmator Pro, you can automatically resize quite easily any image, whether you took it with a CleanShot or not. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.